It is 6:30 now. Again, we are continuing to follow the very latest developments after an explosion at an oil drilling platform in the Gulf of Mexico, about 52 miles southeast of Venice. Plaquemines Parish President Billy Nungesser right now joining us live on the phone for the very latest information. President Nungesser, first let's start off with the injury count. What are we at right now?
Well, there's 9 to 15 people still not accounted for. Earlier this morning, they located and had a visual contact with one of the rescue capsules off the rig, but they don't know if all those people are on. They're not hopeful they are, and all will be accounted for.
Okay, so there were 126 people on board, correct? So all but 15 have been accounted for.
Right. There were 4 airlifted to Belchase Naval Air Station and transported by ambulance to the hospital. 2 of those have been released. The other 2 are still there. I understand the critical condition, but we don't have any word from the hospital as of yet.
So did you say 4 injuries, 2 critical condition?
Right. 2 of the 4 that were transported there have been released. There are 2 still there. There were several, 2 of the rescue boats that showed up on the scene had medical facilities on the boats. These are research vessels, and they were able to treat some of the minor injuries on the scene offshore. As the people were rescued out of the water.
Now, is the platform still on fire right now, President?
Yes, it is. It's a large drilling rig. It's one of the large floaters in the deep water, so it's a massive facility, and it is leaning very bad to one side. And the Coast Guard commander I met with in Venice said there's a good chance it will roll over later on in the day. He doesn't think it'll stay right side up.
Around what time did this happen, and what exactly do we know about how this happened? And give us the idea of firefighting efforts and search efforts overnight.
Yeah, there's 4. I understand there's 4 fire boats fighting the flames on the scene. I got a call. I believe it was right after 10, between 10 and 11 o'clock last night, and we don't know what, you know, obviously the company that owns the rig has not, we haven't talked to anyone with the company yet, so we don't know the cause or the condition of the rig at this time.
And what company is it that owns the rig?
It's Trans Ocean Atlantis, and the name of the rig was the Deepwater Horizon.
Okay, what can you tell us maybe about, is this a situation where we're concerned about a potential oil spill there?
Well, hopefully the fire, the oil will be burned off. I'm sure the company will have boats out there as soon as the rescue operation is complete to contain any environmental problems that will be out there. And we are trying to find and contact the company at this point, because as soon as we can let the names of the rescued known, because we are starting to receive some phone calls from people that and I'm glad we mentioned the name of the rig so people know, just because their loved ones work offshore,
right,
that they weren't working on this rig, that they are okay.
Right. Now, and this is, I believe, diesel we're talking about how many barrels?
Oh, I don't know. This was a large rig. It did a lot of production, so I don't know the extent of that. We won't know that until the reports get in from offshore.
So what effects is this ultimately having on the waterway for how long right now from what we can see at this moment?
Well, it's way offshore, so it doesn't have any effect really on the river transportation or you know, vessels coming in and out of Venice. Obviously, it'll be a drop in production because this rig will be offline. And then, you know, the people at service, all the food supply and all of the supplies to that rig will feel the impact somewhat, especially with the oil field being slow as it is now. So the impact to the area will be felt. But we're just hoping at this point that all the people are rescued and found okay.
And so those 15 people still remain missing this morning. I believe we have a helicopter. There's a helicopter out there, a few boats. Is that correct? How big is the search effort for those 15 people?
There's three Coast Guard helicopters from the Belchase Naval Air Station and one from Mobile, Alabama, that's on the scene now searching for that lifeboat.
Okay, and we do believe the Coast Guard, you said earlier, I guess in the middle of the night, did see a lifeboat with perhaps these 15 people on it.
They did spot a lifeboat with people on it. They just didn't know how many.
Okay, so we're hoping for the best there. And, of course, thank you for your updates this morning. Plaquemines Parish President Billy Nungesser, this about an oil drilling platform that exploded overnight just around between 10 and 11 o'clock at night. Again, the search still continues this morning for 15 people, and we will continue to bring you the very latest. 126 people were on board that rig. All of them have been accounted for except for those missing 15. Two people critically injured this morning, four injured, and all have been taken to the Belchase Naval Air Station. Those with injuries, several had minor injuries as well. So we'll continue to keep you updated with the very latest on that story.